Cuando un niño es abandonado, cuando una persona anciana es marginada, no es solamente un acto de injusticia, pero también demuestra cómo ha fallado nuestra sociedad. Cuidando a nuestros niños y a nuestras personas ancianas es la única opción que tenemos como civilización.
Entonces, a Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., what we do today, we do in solidarity, these are my words, out of love for our city, our cities over the entire nation, and out of love for Miss Canada. All of our grandmothers. And from the Reverend Dr. King Jr., there comes a time when silence is betrayal. Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about the things that matter. There comes a time when one must take a position that is neither safe nor politic nor popular, but he or she must take it because conscience tells he or she it is right. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Only darkness cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Only light can drive out hate. What we do today together in solidarity all over this nation is because we love the tenants and renters of San Francisco, and we love this Canada. And I thank you, and if you will allow me to say, I bless all of you for your presence today. Thank you.
Thank you.
En San Francisco, inquilinos a través de la nación, ¿verdad? Estamos levantándonos como inquilinos por todas partes. Y ahora quiero leer unas palabras del doctor Martin Luther King. Y él dice, viene un tiempo cuando quedarnos callados es una decepción. Ok, otra vez. Hay un tiempo cuando quedarnos callados es una decepción. Nuestras vidas empiezan y terminan el minuto que nos callamos sobre las cosas que importan. Hay un momento donde tenemos que tomar una posición que no es ni segura, ni política, ni popular. Pero tenemos que tomarla porque nuestra conciencia nos dice que es lo justo. La oscuridad no puede sacar a la oscuridad. Solamente la luz puede hacer eso. El odio no puede acabar con más odio. Solamente el amor puede hacer eso. Solamente la luz puede sacar al odio. Estamos aquí porque amamos a nuestra ciudad, a nuestros inquilinos, y porque amamos a la señora Canadá.
Point the speaker out. The speaker, point the speaker out.
Just in the essence of time. Can you hear me?
No.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just in the interest of time, I'll introduce myself again for those of you who didn't hear. I'm Freddie from Housing Rights Committee of San Francisco.
I'm Alicia Sandoval, organizadora y consejera con Housing Rights Committee.
Yeah. And right. Thank you for coming out today. Thank you for taking your time. And we're just going to go right into the program of the speakers. and he's very, very, very active in saving affordable housing in the community.
This is not San Francisco.
Good morning.
Morning.
Let me give all honor and praise to the Most High. My spirit is really moved to see so many of you out here that are conscious enough to know that the banksters and the robbers are still trying to steal and rob this community of its history, of its culture. And I think the measure of a city is how they treat the widows, the orphans. How do they treat our elderly? And this is shameful that a woman that is 100 years old, we should be here celebrating the Most High for giving us to know that we can live beyond a retirement age, that we can live long enough to have walking institutions that can share the history of this city and of this nation and of this world. But instead, what do we have? We have some gangsters. We have some banksters. We have some greedy people trying to put a 100-year-old woman in the street. Where are the preachers? Where are those that are calling for the moral authority? Where are they? How could you sleep today and know that this kind of thing is happening? I'm so glad that those that are involved and committed, I happen to be a dues-paying member of ACE. I'm also with the Justice for Mario Woods, Alexis Sonejo, Jessica, and all of those that have been murdered by these police that think that they can get a paid vacation by killing black and brown. But this is ridiculous.
Yes.
We can't let this thing go. Where is the man? Where are those folks that have been elected to protect this city at a time like this? So I just want to encourage everybody, let's stay in touch with all of the organizations that are committed to saving the dignity of our elders. There's elder abuse going on. And those that are in authority are sound asleep. Or if they're not asleep, they are a part of it. And we need to pull the covers off of everybody that is involved in this crime. That's what it is. It's a crime against the elderly. Compassion, can I play blow? Un dia, tomorrow, supremo.
Thank you. Let Ira stay. Let Ira stay. Let Ira stay.
It's good to be here. It's good to see so many people from all walks of life. From the Mission to Western Addition. Give it up for yourself one time, San Francisco.
Alright.
We got Hardest Point in the house. We got Bay View from D11 to D5. The people said no longer, no more. Basta, we're done. You're not going to evict a 100-year-old woman out of her house.
No.
It's not going to happen, is it?
No.
Alright, I come from here from Midtown, just down a couple of blocks in the Fillmore.
Long live Midtown!
Yeah, we've been on the red flag for the past year. My friends, my neighbors, about as old as I'm in Canada, are facing constructive eviction because there is one up, a couple of 100%. We said no more. We've been on the fight for the past year. So we stayed here in full support of our neighbor. We cannot let another elderly black woman be evicted out of the house.
Yeah.
We cannot let gentrification tear apart our neighborhood, tear apart our community, and throw us out to Vallejo, to outside the city that we built.
Right.
We're working class people, aren't we?
Yeah.
We built this city, we're going to stay here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. back of the street and you're just tying it up, so
hundreds of miles from where we live. If you are hated and you live here, we have the right to live here. We have the right. How many employees do you know went to school in San Francisco? They work in San Francisco, but you can't afford to live in San Francisco. It's time for a change. And I believe if we continue to do these types of gatherings and lifting our voices, we will win. But we must continue the fight. It's not just a wonderful thing, but it's time for us to go ahead and pack the hall of the supervisor meeting. We should pack that room saying, enough is a day enough. We're going to stop putting people in office who are not for us. I want to know, where is London Breed?
Since I was 100 years old, how
this happen. We cannot let this happen.
Yeah.
We
yeah.
have to let Iris stay. We have to let all people in San Francisco stay here.
Yeah.
We have the right to stay. Yeah. That's what we are here for. Let Iris stay.
Are evicted from their home.
Thank you.
años y había vivido en su apartamento por 40 años. Y si ustedes piensan, yo sé que ustedes no piensan que el desalojo no causa la muerte porque ustedes están aquí, pero la realidad es, y ustedes la saben, que cuando alguien empieza un proceso de desalojo, eso afecta su salud. Y el efecto negativo a la salud de un anciano, eso es grave. Y entonces, también es importante reconocer que no estamos solos, somos muchos aquí en San Francisco, pero también hoy es el Día Nacional de Acción, así que estamos aquí y con una docena de otras acciones que están ocurriendo, no solamente en el área de la bahía, pero más de 40, más de 45 otras acciones a través de la nación. Así que cuando nos levantamos, cuando nos unimos, cuando estamos organizados, no solamente localmente, pero a todos los niveles, incluyendo nacional, sabemos que podemos mover montañas. Así que gracias a todos por estar aquí y pues le vamos a seguir y vamos a estar haciendo este trabajo porque sabemos que hasta que los que están en la alcaldía, que están en el Capitolio en Sacramento, nos escuchen y hagan los cambios que necesitemos, vamos a tener que seguir trabajando. Y gracias a todas las organizaciones que están aquí, Causa Justa, Defenders Union, Comité de Vivienda San Francisco, SAMCAS, y todas las organizaciones que están aquí, Faith and Action. Así que gracias a todos.
March right now, basically, we're going to march down to Haight and Fillmore. We'll have some more speakers. I believe I read the
George, hope you have some good news.
I enjoy yours too. Thank you.
Thank you. so we can...
Yeah, we got it.
Okay.
Munich and Munich.
Since 2015. Where is the investigation?
absolutely criminal. The penal code says so. So I don't know when the laws become operative as it relates to Irish Canada, but again, Peter Owens has said in his own words, Irish Canada has done nothing. What we all know is that Irish Canada at 98 could not defend a lawsuit. What we know that Irish Canada, once she had a stroke, could not present in court. But instead of the court saying, hey, the woman's had a stroke, she can't properly defend herself, the court actually punished her and gave her issue sanctions and monetary sanctions. This is what your court system did. The judge had a letter from her doctor. We didn't make up that she had a stroke. She had a stroke. You don't plan for these things. You don't plan to be sick. So I guess Peter Owens and the other occupants want Iris to plan her illnesses and let them know so that they won't make the mistake and say that she moved. Everything in court is hearsay, and everything in court is a lie that Peter Owens has presented. And Peter Owens has perjured himself and every other person in that building. I am wondering how a judge did not find trial of facts as it relates to Iris Canada and this real property pursuit by Peter Owens. How did the judge miss that? He's been on the bench a long time. He teaches at Hastings. How did he miss it? How did the judge miss the facts around this case? That the person, the defendant, was elderly, that the defendant could not present in court because she had had a stroke, but the judge ruled anyway. I ask you, please ask the judge, because we're going back to court, to take a close look at this. I invite Judge James Robertson to come to Iris Canada's house and look and see, did she move out, as Peter Owens and the other occupants are suggesting. That's what the lawsuit is about, that she moved. So they're punishing her for being in another city, visiting relatives and traveling. They're punishing her for going through a hip replacement. They're punishing her for being sick. They get to take her to court and continue to lie. An organized lie is always better than a disorganized truth. And a 98-year-old can't organize, neither can she pay for legal representation that's mounted against her the way that you have. There are 5 apartments in that building, and each of those apartments have 2 people. Please notice every article that comes out, they troll it. They write all kinds of bad comments about Iris Canada. And when they can't write bad comments about Iris Canada, they write bad comments about me. They say that we're holding up the process. We're holding up the process. Peter Owens sued Iris Canada. Peter Owens held up the process, and the other occupants in the building. So I'm not clear why we should ever trust Peter Owens or any of the occupants in the building to have any control over the life and livelihood of Iris Canada. But with that life and state that has a covenant in it, and covenants are illegal and run against public policy, Iris Canada has a covenant on her life and state that she paid for that says she has to be the sole occupant in her unit. Wow. She signed it under duress because she thought she was the evicted. This is what Peter Owens did. But Peter Owens is one of the think leaders in this country. Let's remember that Peter Owens is a think leader in this country. He was the Community and Economic Development Director for Burlington, Vermont. Community and Economic Development Director for Burlington, Vermont. He had the privilege of the public trust to create affordable housing. But what is he doing in San Francisco? He's a prospector removing rental housing from the market. This is what you want your country to look like. This is who you want your think leaders to be. Look into it very, very seriously. If that building converts to condo, it's a crime. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Peter Owens, shame on you. Peter Owens.
Video. In that journal. But a couple of 2-3 days we put a video on. Okay.
My name is Roger Scott. I'm with the American Federation of Teachers Local que no solamente están escritos, pero que se practican. Solamente unidos como comunidades latinas y afrodescendientes serán nuestras voces escuchadas para ya no más ser abusados por los ricos. Aunque seamos pobres, merecemos dignidad y que nuestra humanidad se respete. Hemos venido a tomar esta acción para la señora Iris y esperamos seguir y que no nos detenga nada hasta que se acaben los desalojos, porque tenemos derecho a la ciudad y para vivir en paz. Le llamamos a los dueños de propiedad y a los legisladores de nuestra ciudad para que tomen cuenta de lo que está pasando aquí. Hoy somos nosotros, pero mañana pueden ser ustedes, compañeros. Gracias.
So my name is Rosa Andres. Can y'all hear me better? My name is Rosa Andres. I'm a member of Causa Justa. I've been living in San Francisco for 16 years. I'm a mom, a worker, and an immigrant. I'm here because we're all fighting for our homes. We've lived through an incredible amount of discrimination here in the Bay Area, being oppressed because we're poor. I'm interested, I'm here to support Ms. Iris Canada's case because there's not any respect for seniors in this city. There's no love for your neighbor. There's no heart. There's no care. And we're here because we believe in justice. I'm also fighting for my own home. We've been living in our apartment the whole 16 years that we've lived in San Francisco. And now the owner is trying to evict us because we refuse to be a part of his corrupt plan to illegally increase everybody's rent in the apartment.
Damn.
And so he threatened my, when I stood up to him, he threatened my housing. He told me that if I didn't raise everybody's rent illegally so that he could make more money, I would be evicted. I didn't want to do it because even though we're poor, an immigrant, it doesn't mean we don't understand the law and we don't respect it. And we don't understand that the laws in San Francisco and in California that protect tenants need to be respected. And because I refuse to be used as a divide and conquer pawn by our landlords. Before, I always did what the landlord told me. I thought he was a good person. But I came to realize that every year he would change my contract. He never did the repairs and the maintenance that he's responsible for. And he just wasn't actually practicing the laws. The landlord tried to take his home out of rent control. He tried to say that his house was not rent controlled so that he could do whatever he wanted with it. We went to the rent board, we made our, we stood for our rights, and we were able to ensure that the house continues to be under rent control. Us that are fighting for our home, but tomorrow it might be you. So that's why we need to stick together. Thank you.
Can we give a big round of applause to Rosa? That was her first time speaking at an audience. Que darle un aplauso a Rosa. Fue la primera vez que ella hablaba en una acción. Le podemos dar todo el apoyo a la compañera.
Housing is under attack. What do we do?
Stand up,
Even more powerful. Let's remember that today is National Renters
least 5 different actions happening today. We started it all here in San Francisco. It's going to keep going to Oakland, to Fremont, to Richmond, to Concord. We are having actions all over the Bay Area, and it just keeps going. I was raised in a little tiny sleepy town in Southern California called Santa Barbara. They are having an action today. That is how powerful our tenants' rights movement is. It is people are joining. So, just to remind us again about why we're here, we are not just here to demand that Ms. Iris's eviction is stopped immediately, although that is a huge demand. We want Ms. Iris's eviction to be stopped immediately and that she is allowed to live the rest of her life in peace, in her home. We are also here to make some national demands, some demands at the national level that include, that connect to our local fights here. One of our demands, and this is a demand that all of the thousands of tenants that I've been talking about are asking for. One, we demand, and maybe we'll do a people's mic version of this, so I'll say it and you guys say it back to me. Ready? We demand a national rent freeze. A national livable rent. And a national livable wage for all people. Can we just take a minute to let that hit us for a second? Imagine if there was a national rent freeze on all rent increases. If we were able to have a livable rent, and if we were able to have a living wage, how amazing would that be? Right? Estamos despiertos. All right. The second demand is we demand and declare a freeze on all unjust evictions. All unjust evictions need to stop at this moment. The third demand is we demand community control over land and housing in our community. How many of you are fighting irresponsible development in your neighborhood right now? Luxury development that is just not doing your community any good. We demand that we make those decisions, that we control the land and the housing in our neighborhood so we can say what we needed. And the last demand is that we demand the right for all tenants to organize and bargain collectively without fear of retaliation or eviction from their landlords. Just like unions, just like workers deserve to be able to organize collectively and bargain collectively, so do tenants. Organizing for our homes is our right. And it is our responsibility. So, I'm about to translate for myself, but the other thing I wanted to lift up today, 1 year ago, on this day, we passed Eviction Protections 2.0. Who was there for us that day? Who was there with us that day? Do y'all remember passing Eviction Protections 2.0?
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. Y'all seem real quiet. But we did it, and that was a year ago today. So we are not just marking a historic moment of uprising by tenants all over the country, but we're also here as an anniversary party for one of the strongest tenant protections that we've been able to pass in the last couple of years. So give yourselves a round of applause. Entonces, compañeros,
y al final, el derecho a poder organizar en nuestro todas esas demandas de los exigencias que acabo de mostrar son exigencias a nivel nacional. Es súper importante estar aquí. Gracias a todos por estar tan fuertes, haciendo lucha. La otra cosa que quiero recordar es que hace un año pasamos la protección en contra de los desalojos 2.0. Una de las protecciones más fuertes en contra de los desalojos que hemos podido pasar en los últimos años. Así que estamos aquí para celebrar el Día Nacional de Inquilinos. Estamos aquí para celebrar que miles de inquilinos por toda la nación se están levantando para luchar en contra del amordazamiento y el desplazamiento. Y también estamos aquí para celebrar el aniversario de un año de una lucha, de una de las mejores protecciones que hemos podido pasar. Así que denle un aplauso.
Yeah, we have one last speaker, very briefly, and then we'll be the
first. Out of battery. Sorry, I've never done this. Hi, everybody. So
my home for 22 years, and I've been in California since I was 21 years old.
Okay. Is that better? Oh, all right. I've been in my home for 22 years, and on June 3rd, I got a 60-day notice that said the landlord said she was taking my rent from $3,100 a month, which is not a small amount,
no,
to $8,500 a month, which is almost triple if you do the math. So, you know, I went to ACE, I went to the tenants union, I went to Tommy over at HRC. I've been all over town trying to find some help. So on September 30th at 11 in the morning, we're going to have an action. And I've been giving people flyers. So if you haven't got one, come and get me, see me, and I'll give you one. We're going to have an action. We're going to ask the manager of the property, the management company, to call the landlord in Novato and tell her to knock it off. Tell her to stop the eviction and, you know, just stop it. Stop this stuff. Knock it off. Everybody's living in fear. San Francisco is going to be a city of white rich people. We're going to lose our diversity. People are going to be enslaved. And people who have been here for a long time are the history holders of San Francisco. They're the people that know what has been going on in their neighborhoods. We all need to come together more like we're doing today and fight for each other. Because if it hasn't happened to you already, it will happen to you. And you will be glad that people come to you to have your back. You'll be glad when other people show up for you. So please, let's show up for each other. And please show up for me on the 30th at 11 a.m. on the corner of Gary and Spruce. And if you can't do that, call the number on this flyer and ask the manager of the property to stop his eviction or drop the landlord as a client. Thank you very much. I'm so grateful that you're all out here.